So even though I've had it, well, not too much more time at home in this self-isolation that we're supposed to, that we are doing, and I've been a bit stuck, distracting myself with other things. So I thought the way to do it is to just do a page in one of my magazine journals. Now I have got a video that I will be posting soon on how to put together one of these magazine art journals, like a junk journal, but it's just a magazine. The colours I'm going to use today, I don't know where this is going, I don't know what I'm doing, so I'm going to start with these two Jo Sonja colours. The Mountain Peak is, if you can see, really light blue, grey blue, and the Shibori is a purple, and then I thought I'd accent it with this peachy colour on top. So we're just going to start and see what happens, yeah, because I've got to get out of this rush. And I don't know why I'm in it, but it's not working for me, so here we go. I do like this colour, it's like a purpley blue, it's almost a blue really, isn't it? Probably got some red in it. So I'm just going to try and do this quick without thinking, because this is the way, if I get a bit of a creative block, I just start and then see what happens, because I'm thinking too hard about some of my other projects and chopping myself out of it. So I like how this is picking up the texture underneath of the page. What I love about the magazine journals is that they're quite rustic. So I'm just going to put this in some places. I might brush it in. It might disappear, so I might scrape it in. Oh yeah, I like that. Really, really like that. This is just a paint scraper. I think it's a paint scraper I got in the paint department at my local Bunnings, some hardware store. So I went searching for new tools a couple of weeks ago before we all got shut down, and this is what I've found, and I've used it quite a bit. I just love texture. That's yummy. I'm just going to dry that off. So that's all dry. I've put some of this peachy colour on my palette, and this is actually the cover off a takeaway coffee cup. And I thought this would be a great stamp, if you can see how it's got a wavy texture to it. So I took it off, and what I'm going to do is use this as a stamp with the peachy colour. So I'm just going to lightly brush some of the paint on the top of the wavy bits. Oh yeah, look at that. How cool was that? See, you don't have to go and buy you're stuck at home and you're in lockdown, you can find plenty of things around your house that you can use as stencils and stamps. So that's what I'm doing. I really like this peachy on top of that blue Shibori colour, so I like that. That's pretty cool. So dry. And in the meantime, what I'm going to do is make some more. I've got this other colour called Onsen. It's a nice minty, bluey colour. Bluey minty colour. A little bit more blue than mint. But I'm going with the blue here. I do also have another minty colour. Yeah, we might do that too. Let's see. That might be better. So what I've got here is just some stamps and stencils that I made out of hot glue. There's plenty of tutorials on YouTube, but basically all it is you get your hot glue gun and a piece of fake paper, and you just do patterns with your hot glue gun, and then shapes and things like that. And then you can use them as stamps. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use this round one. Some shapes I find are a bit more successful than others. This one obviously I use a lot. That one I have used as well. This one I use a lot as well. Some of them don't come out as well as others, but it's pretty hit and miss, so you've just got to roll with the punches. Just got to be open to whatever comes out. So I'm going to try this minty colour. Now I'm just going to put some of the paint on the pencil and just press it in. Yeah, that colour is good. I like that. I like this colour combination. I don't usually do pastels, so I'm going out of my comfort zone today. Yep, I really like how that fits. I like these colours. This is way out of my comfort zone, guys. Now what I'm going to do, this is a really old script stamp, so, and I've had paint on it before, so I'm not too bothered if this is still a bit wet. You can dry it, of course, but for the purpose of this video, I've just got some archival ink. And I'm just going to randomly stamp. It's not meant to stand out, it's just meant to be in the background. Just adding some depth. Making sure I'm doing both pages. Crossing over so that I've crossed that stamp over to there. I've overlapped it so it doesn't look as if I've tried to do it on one page and not the other. I'm making sure I've got it over the top of my painted areas. Okay, so I've dried that off. while I was drying, of course I went into the overthinking mode, and then I just thought, nope, I'm just going to grab a few things and start moving along. So all I'm doing is putting out some white, titanium white, and I'm just going to brayer on some another white onto the page. Just going to break it up a little bit. I don't want it thick. I don't want it all over, put it that way. I don't mind if you stick it around this. I don't want it all over. Because I'm thinking I want to glaze. Alright, we'll do it all over. That's happening now. So I like that you can still see the pattern through it. But I have got some thicker areas of white. Alright, so I'm not going to worry about drying that. I've got some heart-shaped sequin waste, and what I'm going to do is have some pale gold. I've just got a little makeup sponge. I'm just going to randomly do some gold. I just wanted another I think the colour that I'm going to use over the top of this will be good for glazing. When I was in my station as Officeworks the other day, they were selling out some Matisse structure paint, and I'm going to try and use it as a glaze. I haven't used Matisse before, but this is a phthalo turquoise, a southern ocean blue, and I just thought it might be nice over the top of the gold and the other colours. So I'm going to be using a synthetic fan brush. And I'll just grab some paint out of here. Well, that's nice. That's very nice. Look at that beautiful colour. Yum. Okay. So, I can see myself using that in my paintings. So I'm just going to water it down a little bit. And just see what it looks like over the top. Oh yeah, that's nice. So I don't want to cover up all of the underneath mint or the peachy or the gold, so I'm just going to rub it around in areas just so it picks up some of the white. That's why I did the white layer, so that we could glaze. Yeah, I quite like that. And it does go quite nicely over that base blue and purple colour, which I'm really happy about. And it looks really nice over the gold as well. So I'm twisting my brush so that I don't get softer edges and I don't have lines. A bit darker in the corners, geez, I love that. That is such a gorgeous colour. And come into these corners. I think what we might do is just frame the whole page in this. Oh, and that's thunder you can hear in the background. We're having a bit of a storm at the moment. So I'm just going back now and making some areas a bit darker where I think it needs it. I'm sort of liking that you can see little areas peeking through. I'm just going to extend that one. And just tone that down a little bit. I love that. Okay, so that's nice and dry, and I've just got my chalk pencil because I just want to do some blossoms. As I found a quote about gratitude. Gratitude is the fairest blossom which springs from the soul, by Henry Ward Beecher. So I always try to practice gratitude, and I think in this, particularly in this time, we've got to be grateful for what we've got, while giving kindness and compassion to those that have lost people and their freedom. So yeah, we're going to get through this. We're all in this together, aren't we? So this is the quote that I am focusing on today. So I just thought, with a blossom, let's maybe pick over here. Yep, okay, you know what, I'm just going to go for it, because I said this was going to be quick, so I need it to be quick, otherwise I'm overthinking it, aren't I? So I've just got a white Posca pen, I'm just going to draw the shape. It's going to be very simple because we're quick. This is not realism at all. I do find that these magazine journals, because the pages are glossy, they take so long to dry if you wet them a lot. So just be mindful of that if you're using a magazine, but it will take a long time to dry. So at the moment I'm just getting in an outline of my shapes and where they're going to be placed. My plan is to write my words here. So now that I'm happy with that shape, I'm actually going to find a really thick foster paper. So now I'm happy with that shape, I'm just going to go over them. Hopefully this works. And I'll just make those round a bit bigger. Bit of that tear underneath, but that's okay. I can sort of see a person there, so I think subconsciously that's why I'm not going near it. But what we'll do with this is I'm trying to work out whether I fill in the background with white or a darker colour, or do I colour in the flowers, the blossoms, and think I'm actually going to do something in the background. Whether that's light or dark, that is the question. So, I think what I'm going to do is do it light. So I might mix it, actually, I just thought of something. I might mix it with a bit of this turquoise. See what that looks like. I know I'm going to cover up some of the background, but that's the way it goes. But I'm not going to cover it at all up, so... So this is very much dry brushing. This brush really wasn't wet. I did dip it in water just to soften it up a little bit, but I haven't dipped in water then. There's a brush mix here of white and teal. Quite like that. And if you'll notice, I'm not mixing up this this colour all at once. I'm actually doing it as I go, and I do that now virtually with every art journal spread or painting, because that's the way that you get very organic mixtures and a bit of texture and a bit of difference. And then you can always come back over the top of it as well. A lot of my pages, I end up going back and forth, back and forth. And this might have to go, but there we go, maybe in the background. You can see I have kept some of the background. I haven't covered it all up. Now, what I want to do with this, I'm actually going to glaze the inside of these with this teal colour, so I'm hoping that works. Now what I'm going to do is bring back the shading that I had around the outside of the page. So I lost that a bit, which is fine. So I do want to bring that back just a touch. I'm not pressing hard because I don't want to lift the paint underneath. I'm just doing a frame. Right, just going to come back. Right. I normally put this everywhere, just to have a few bright areas. Okay. And if I'm laying the brush flat rather than up like that, this is how you pick up the texture. So I'm going to dry that now because I'm going to come back with the Posca pen and then do my writing. I just realised we might need a bit more in the background here so I can write. Okay, so I'll dry this off and then we'll come back and we'll finish it off. Now what I thought was I want to bring back the gold that's here, and so what I'm going to do is mind that it's sort of looking sketchy, quite like that. Okay, so let's do the flowers, and I've got a, So I've got a lettering brush, or you could just use a liner brush. I haven't really looked after that one, which is naughty because it's actually a sable. Use this one. So I'm dipping into pale gold, which is what we used in the background for the stencil. Now you can use a pen if you've got a gold Posca pen. You can certainly use that if you would prefer. So all I'm doing is just going over to the top of the white. Actually, I think before I do that, I'm going to do the writing, because I bet you when I come back to do the writing, I'll put my hand in that. So what I want to do is, now I've got this identipen, but it's any black marker, your favorite black marker. It can be a Tombow, it can be a Posca pen. Today I'm going to use this one. So we just get our quote. I've got a black Posca, hopefully it works. Well, that's not what I wanted. Oops. Bit of a malfunction here. This is obviously a pin that's gonna leak. I'm gonna be careful not to press. Right, I think it's still wet, so I'm gonna just dry it again and then I'll come back. Okay, so what I did then was I just wet that area and then just dabbed it out. And then I thought I'd spray it with matte spray because maybe that's why it's not picking up. I also went and got another black pen. So hopefully this is better, but it's not looking that way. That one's better. Okay, that writes much better. Right, so what I'm going to do while that dries is do another, do the gold on here. Just to get it a little bit of here. And doing this gold outline, it also picks up the gold stencil I did before. Okay, now black, that's the only place that we've got black. What I'm going to do is actually do a black outline around that side of the warm flowers as well. But what I thought for now, while I've still got the gold out, I'm just going to splatter. And I can't see it, but it is there. outline to the body bits. I'm probably getting more on everything else than I am on the page. I sort of like that, this string. Weird, I know. I'm weird. But we're going for it, aren't we? I'm not second guessing ourselves. Okay. So, yeah, I got gold all over everything. What I thought I might do is gold pen. I don't know whether it'll work on this. Well, just not sure of the black. How do we do the gold? And then do the black as the shadow. That might be better. So all I'm doing is writing over the top. Hopefully the pen will last. I'm trying not to touch the foils. Yeah, I think I need to do the next spray on. I'm being quite sketchy with this one, a little bit thicker. Now that I've decided I'm going to come back with the black as the shadow. Okay, so what we'll come back now is we have got, we will come back with the need something else. I'm not having much luck with my pens today, am I? Now you know why I've got so many pens on my desk. Because sometimes some work and then they just decide to stop for a while. And it's funny, they don't get rid of them and then they start working again. So it's really weird. I'm just putting a shadow on the underneath and the left hand side of the letter. You can, if you don't press too hard, I should go and lift the paint. It's better to be dry than try and press too hard. There, that makes it stand out. If I wasn't videoing, I would dry this off. But now I'm impatient, so at the risk of wearing the pen. Yep, that looks good. So there you go, there's a page of my magazine journal. Hope you've enjoyed that little distraction from what's going on in the world today, and I hope you get your art journals out and have a little play with some paints. Stay safe, everyone.